Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. Let's continue with our Svelte special elements. We've talked about Svelte self and Svelte components. Today we're going to talk about Svelte window. So let's take a look at some examples on when we can use this Svelte window and what is it about. So over here, we have our application. So sometimes you want to listen to window events. For example, over here, we try to listen to resize because we want to get the window's inner width. Right? So we listen to on the window and then you listen to this event listeners and then get the window inner width. So every time when you resize, you get a new value. Right? So as you can see here, the width self is changing because I'm resizing the window. And sometimes you want to also listen to events, for example, key down in this case. So it's the same case previously as we listen to resize and then we get the property from the window. And this time we are listen to events and try to react to it, right? So this time, this one, when we add event listeners like key down, for example, when you click Control F, you will want to focus on this input bar rather than having the default browser behavior, which is event prevent default, right? Prevent the default behavior from the browser, which is to do a global search like here. Let's see, something like this, a global search. You want to change that, you want to focus over here instead. So how you would usually do is you would maybe wait for a component to be mounted. So you add the event listeners in onMount and remember to return a function to clean it up so that you don't lead to like a memory leak. So yes, you can do it this way, but today we'll talk about Svelte window, right? And Svelte window is actually a way for you to add event listeners and read out some properties such as inner width from the window without having to manually set up your event listeners and listen to it and update it. So let's take a look at maybe the first one, which is this one, which is closer so that we can change one by one. So here we listen to the key down event and we add this, call this event handler, right? So an alternative would be having a Svelte window element and we add this event listeners over here. So you can treat this special element, Svelte window, like your window element, except it won't render anything. So there's nothing being rendered. There's nothing new, there's no new element created by this special element itself, but rather this special element is here for you to add event listeners. So here I can add on key down and let's copy this event handler, let's collapse this and comment all of them on key down. So pass this in over here. And let's try to click Control F and everything still works. So you can write this instead using on key down. And the same thing as how you add event listeners with elements, Svelte will take care for you when you want to unmount this component. You remember to remove the event listeners from window. So this is a slightly shorter version of writing all that we have written so far. Adding event listeners and remove event listeners when we don't need it. All right, so Svelte window again is a special element so that you can do this on a window object. Another example that we've seen so far is to add a resize and then read this inner width. Right, so we can add also, we can come over here and add this on resize and this event listeners called on resize. I'm gonna copy all this. I wouldn't say all this, but it's just a few lines over here. On resize, copy this and pass it over here. Right, so now when we resize our width, you can see that we still update the value. We still have this event listeners and update this value in a width, right? Is there a better way? Is there a shorter way? I wouldn't say better, but it's like shorter way of writing this. Yes, there's actually a shorter way of writing this, which is if you which is you can use a binding, right? Binding is like a two-way binding, where you can bind, you can set the width of the window. Well, I'm not sure whether you can, but you can also, when an event's happening, you will update this variable from the property of your element, right? In this case, the element is window. We want to listen to some event. We want Svelte to handle that, know what events to listen, and listen to that event, and then update our variable. So we can actually bind inner width over here instead of writing an on resize. So let me comment this. Let me remove this. Let's come over here, bind inner width. And I'm going to bind to the variable with the same name. Right, so there's a shorthand of writing there for binding, which is just do this. And now we can even go ahead and remove this on resize handler. And everything still works fine. So what are the things that you can bind to and what are the events you can listen to? Well, for events, you can listen to all the events that is available on window or any elements, right? But most, but of course, it's on. You make sure that it makes sense to listen on to the window, right? So you can basically listen to any events. You can there's no restriction over here. But for binding on window elements, there is some of the things that you can do. So here I'm at the tutorial for Svelte. And this chapter where it says Svelte binding, you'll see that there's a few properties that you can bind to. So inner width, inner heights, outer width, outer heights, scroll X, scroll Y, and online. So you can bind all this variable. So the first four is more about the window size. And as you can see here, everything except scroll X and scroll Y are read only. Meaning, although you are using a two-way binding, the binding, but you only have one direction from it, which is from the element events and then update your variable. Instead of having a variable updates them, right? It does not make sense that you have a variable that can update, can change the window size, right? That is most of the case I use. That is only user draggable, like resizable height and width, right? As well as online status, right? Online, whether the user is connected to the internet or not. You can't change the user's connectivity. You can only have events like the online and offline events from the window and then read this property out of window the navigator. Although of course scroll X and scroll Y, you can change both ways, right? You can change the scroll position or get the scroll position to change your variable. So these are things that you can bind to the window. And instead of writing your own event listeners on a window object, you can use this Svelte special element called Svelte window. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya. Bye bye.